So let's say this is a folder in your Google Drive and you want to share just a single document, right? If you right click on it, select share, and then if you know who you want to share it with, you can specify that single person. There's other ways to do it too. I can link to a video on that. So you would left click on send, and then your coworker would come in and they would check the shared with me folder. That file would show up in their shared with me folder. Let's put these two windows side by side and talk about what we're seeing here. This is the same file. It is owned by the account in the left, but it's shared with the account on the right. But if you're doing this with 4, 5, 6, 7 different people, you're going to run into problems because people are going to leave. They're going to change their files, and you can't have a centralized way to control them and their permissions until you do shared drives. So let's take a look at shared drives. It is at a paid level of Google Drive. So this is just a page listing the different levels of Workspace. It comes in what's now called Business Standard. Shared drives for your team. So it's available here in all the higher levels. I have it in my two accounts, so we'll come back, we'll take a look at it. Let's go down to shared drives, and we'll come into the account on the right as well and go to shared drives. So right away you can see something going on here where my account on the left has 3 of these, but the account on the right only has 2. And that's because you can control the permissions, the members and the files on each one of these shared folders. So we'll look at videos first. I just created this. Let's say I work on videos with 3 different people. So if I right click on manage members, this is the account on the left, account on the right. And then I added a 3rd one. And if you'll notice, this 3rd person isn't even part of the organization. It's not the same custom email address. And that's fine. You can add those members to a shared drive. And a very important aspect of this is the account on the top is the one that created it. And let's left click on these levels so you get the highest level of permissions and you can control everyone else's permissions. So if we look at Michael, I made him a content manager. That means he can do almost everything except change the people in their settings. You could have a level where you can't delete files and where you can only comment or only just see the files. So you're already seeing advantage over sharing individual files is that when you put them in a shared drive, let's double click on this. They're all in one place. They're all owned by the shared drive, not by any individual user. And they're all controlled at the shared drive level. So you can manage the members that we just looked at. You can email all the members at once. You can also control some other things, like you could turn off the outside sharing if you wanted. If you were just in a company where you had some intellectual property you wanted to protect, I would leave that checked. And you can also control the sharing on individual files inside if you want, and you can turn that off. All right, so let's go back to shared drives and take a look here. So you can create as many as you want. And another powerful feature is that each one can have different members. So in this case, I said, look, I'm just the one that does the accounting here. I add it to a shared drive though, because let's say come tax season, I right click on here, I choose manage members, and I add in my outside accountant, right? Maybe he does my books before tax time, does a tax return, and then we're done, I just take him back off. And again, you could do that in a free account if you want, but you don't have nearly the level of control, you don't see it all in one place like we do with shared drives. Now another very important difference here is if we take a look at my file explorer, I've installed Google Drive File Stream. There's 2 different programs that Google offers to sync your files. You can use Google Backup and Sync, or you can use Drive File Stream if you have a paid account. But what you can do with Drive File Stream is that you can see your shared drives, right? So if I double click on here, we're seeing the same thing. So you have full access to open them with applications that are on your computer and manage them this way too. If I double click on videos, I see the same files. So if the person that owns this account on the right had Google Drive File Stream installed, they would see the same files that are shared with them in these 2 folders. All right, so now let's talk about some of the other differences between a free Google Drive account and a paid Google Drive account. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in that next video.